The time has finally come. Riku versus Tigerwolf. Gundam 00 Sky versus Gundam Geon Ultron. Gundam fight! Ready? Go! As a huge fan of anime, I have a very diverse taste of the stories that I really like to see. Sometimes I like a really good story with great characterization, something that I'd like to equate to a very fine steak. But every once in a while, I just want some junk food. A big, fat, greasy burger of an episode, and that's exactly what we got from this episode of Gundam Build Divers, which ultimately just boils down to Riku versus Tigerwolf. And you know what? It might be one of the best episodes of this season thus far. It also features one of my absolute favorite moments where Riku finally develops his very own special move. And the way that it's portrayed in this episode is all sorts of awesome. What I especially love about this episode is how it went against the grain. It didn't end the way that I was going to expect. So, spoiler warning, if you haven't seen this episode, let's just go ahead and dive right in. So this episode right here is very simple. It's basically Riku versus Tigerwolf, but the reason that it's actually going down is because Tigerwolf finally realizes that Riku is becoming very strong. He has finally become a competent rival, so he decides that he has to fight him, not only to prove himself, but to see how far Riku has actually come as a Gunpla battler. In fact, Riku has actually managed to break into the top 10 competitors in the timed competitions. The first half of the episode is watching him just absolutely destroy a group of Gunpla, which I thought was hilarious, was kind of like an evolution of the Gundam itself. You actually got to see him fight against the original RX-78-2, moving on to the Mark II, the Zeta, the Double Zeta, and on. And it's a great display of his powers. It's in this moment that Tigerwolf knows that he finally has to test this guy, and he's actually going to bring him into this tournament, which is being hosted by his force, known as the Riku Kasai, and he's going to battle against him and the other members of the Toraburyu, which they do show a little bit of, but mostly it's a build-up to the battle between Tigerwolf and Riku. And this battle, guys, is awesome. I mean, it's not too groundbreaking in terms of the action that I've actually seen from the series, but it actually has some brand new attacks from both Tigerwolf and Riku in particular. And for the most part, this entire battle is kind of even. I almost expected Tigerwolf to have an extreme advantage here, as he's finally viewing Riku as an actual rival, someone that he doesn't have to hold back on, someone that he can even reveal some secret abilities to. And that's definitely the best thing about this episode. The battle itself, I can't speak for it, you just have to see it. But it's these special moves that they finally unleash on each other, which is definitely the best thing about this episode right here. First, Tigerwolf has a brand new variation on the attack that he's been using throughout most of the series. We do get to see that again in this episode, which unfortunately, yes, does continue to reuse the animation, but luckily he decides to up the ante when he sees that Riku is just blocking this with his wings of light. That's when he uses his brand new attack, which is known as the Raijin Thunder, where the tiger and the wolf on his Gunpla's shoulders actually attach to his fists. They shoot out fire and electricity, combine into one and transform into a massive electrical dragon of destruction, which roars into the sky as it destroys everything in its wake. Not only is Riku able to take this attack, but he's actually able to fight back against it with his very first special move that he's actually created on the fly. What he does is he takes out one of his massive ship-destroying swords, plants it into the ground, and then completely surrounds it with his wings of light energy, which transforms it into this massive beam katana made of pure energy itself, which the Gundam 00 Sky actually has the ability to grab onto. He jumps up into the sky, slams the sword down. This is followed by an amazing shot where you get to see the damage done behind the Geon Ultron, where not only does the sword cut through the Raijin Thunder, but through his Gunpla itself. It doesn't leave any like physical cuts or anything, but it absolutely destroys everything on his Gunpla. And this was an epic moment. I was like, wow, Riku finally did something to me that was truly impressive in the series, and he actually just won this battle. Or did he? You see, the attack was so powerful that his Gunpla was not actually prepared for any of the power behind it, and thus he started to collapse, Tigerwolf caught him, congratulated him on the fact that he developed a new power, but also gives him a little lesson in humility as he kicks him once, slamming him into the wall, and winning the battle, declaring that he is the strongest Gunpla battler. It's a great moment for Tigerwolf. I love the fact that he did not hold back on Riku, and I love that Riku actually lost the battle. He's gonna learn so much more from losing than he would actually from winning at this point. So what's the rundown on this episode of Gundam Build Divers? Ugh! I absolutely loved this battle. I loved the Trans Am Infinity Sword. I loved the Raijin Thunder. The attack just looked so freaking awesome. I was waiting for that tiger and that wolf to combine into some sort of form, and seeing it used as actually his fists was great, especially because he actually ended up losing an arm, and that actually worked out in his favor, allowing him to use a special variation on his techniques. But what I especially loved about this episode was that we actually got some solid characterization from Tigerwolf and from Riku. They're actually growing as characters. It's a shame that it's so late in the series, but there's some also other little moments about this episode I loved. One, we got to go into the past of Tigerwolf just a little bit, showing when he was a rookie, he actually lost to Maggie initially. They're truly building up Maggie to be some sort of amazing badass, and I really hope that eventually he'll get to have a one-on-one battle with Riku as well. Also, again, they dive more into the rivalry between Tigerwolf and Shariar, and it's basically the same as the rest of the series. They're like oil and water, they don't see eye to eye, but you know by the end of the series they're gonna start making out with one another. That being said, it was a little strange that at the very end of the episode, Shariar seemed a little upset over Tigerwolf's victory. Maybe it's because he's actually a little jealous of his rival, maybe it's because he just doesn't like his showboating attitude. But it's interesting. I can't wait to see if this is actually going to develop into something more as the actual series goes on. I also love that they're still slowly building up to the fact that Yuki is building his brand new Gunpla, which still has not been seen yet, and it's a shame that we're barely going to see any of it as the series actually wraps up. But who knows, the way that Gundam Build Divers is going, they could potentially move on to another season, and honestly, I'd kind of like to see that happen, if only for the fact that they could truly build upon this world just a little bit more. Avid viewers will also want to check out the post-credit scene at the very end of the episode, which is still continuing to build on the fact that this bug is taking over the entire GBN world, and they don't know quite what it is, but they're finally starting to see a pattern forming. Eventually, this is all going to lead to Sarah, and ultimately the finale of this series. Will it leave on a cliffhanger? Will we get a definitive ending? We're just going to have to wait and find out. The next episode also looks like it's going to be pretty fun. It's finally going to be a Momo-centric episode, featuring a lot of female characters who are going to be in their very own competition, so I can't wait to see what that's going to be about. But this episode right here was simple, solid, and to the point. In fact, it was probably the first episode of the series that actually kind of felt like a classic episode of Gundam Build Fighters. First half, all about the build-up, preparing your Gundam. Second half, all about the raw, awesome action. This episode delivered. It also had tons of great cameos. Like I said, all the ones from the beginning of the episode with Riku battling against the original Gundams. I even got to see the return of one of my favorite Gundams from G Gundam, the Maxter Gundam, which was in this episode. And Patrick Kolesar's cameo, you're not going to miss it in this episode. He gets his ass handed to him in this big battle during a montage sequence towards the end of the episode. Really, this was a pretty solid one right here, which had some pretty good animation, some unique action, and some brand new attacks from some of our favorite characters. Basically, what I'm saying is, I like this episode. One of my favorites from the entire series, which is why I'm going to give this one, that's right, a 5 out of 5. You guys need to check this one out. If any of you did watch this episode of Gundam Build Divers, I would love to hear your thoughts about it. You can tell me all of them in the comments section below. What did you think of the big battle between Riku and Tigerwolf? Did you like it? Were you disappointed? Did you have any favorite moments? What do you want to see from the rest of the series? Do you have any predictions how it's all going to end? Do you want to see a season 2? Do you want more Gundam Build Divers? Let's start a discussion in the comments section below. Thank you guys so much for watching this review. I'll see you guys next time, and as always, stay Dandel, baby!